From the brewers of premium quality natural light beer, Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, St. Louis, Missouri, we invite you to join us for
Angling Archaeology. This week on Angling Archaeology, we're going to look at the Lazy Ike, an extremely popular bait back in the day with a very loyal following. Let's see, does it catch a fish? I don't know. Stick around and find out. The Lazy Ike first appeared on the scene in the mid to late 1930s, approximately 1938. As the story goes, Newell Daniels of Fort Dodge, Iowa, was fishing on the Des Moines River with a hand-carved lure he created. Now, Joseph Kautzky Jr., the son of a sporting goods store owner, saw Daniels fishing with the lure and said, "Look at that Lazy Ike." Now, I couldn't tell you exactly what he meant, but the name, Lazy Ike, definitely stuck. Now, let's back it up just a little bit. Now, who are the Kautzkys? And by the way, if I'm pronouncing this wrong, I sincerely apologize. Going back to 1897, Joseph Kautzky Sr., an Austrian immigrant, started a small gun shop in Fort Dodge called Kautzky Manufacturing Company. In 1912, Kautzky decided to expand his business and start selling sporting goods. And in 1919, Kautzky moved into 522 Central Avenue in Fort Dodge. Now let's fast forward back to the late 1930s again. After the fishing encounter with Kautzky Jr., Daniels began making the Lazy Ike for Kautzky Sporting Goods from 1938 to 1940. In 1940, Daniels left Kautzky Sporting Goods and gave up the rights of the Lazy Ike. His work was then taken over by Pop Shuck, who handmade them until 1945. In 1945, lathe production started, and this is where we really start to see production ramp up. To give you some perspective, in 1947, 60,000 lures were produced. By 1954, we're looking at 900,000. On December 8, 1956, a fire completely destroyed Kautzky Sporting Goods. However, this didn't stop production. Kautzky's just moved down the street to 510 Central Avenue in 1957. Another thing to note is that people actually collect the surviving charred lures. They call them Fire Ikes. In August of 1961, ownership of Kautzky's Lazy Ike changed to a newly formed West Des Moines firm called Lazy Ike Corporation. Even with the new ownership, however, the Lazy Ike operations would still remain in Fort Dodge, Iowa. Moving forward to 1979, the Lazy Ike Corporation files for Chapter 11 bankruptcy. In 1981, Durapac Corporation acquires Lazy Ike, who is then acquired by Great American Fishing Supply Company in 1988, and finally by Pradco in 1991. Sadly, Pradco has decided not to continue making the Lazy Ike. However, with millions made over time, it's definitely not hard to find one on eBay. And let's be honest, it's much more fun to fish with these vintage lures anyways. Now, before we jump into fishing, let me just show you what we're working with this week. Once again, we've got the Luz ultralight combo right here. It's a laser light. And this is the setup right here. Now, this is how you set up the Lazy Ike. So, and this is a newer one. And how you can tell that is it's plastic. Now, pre-1960, they look like this. And they were wood. And you probably saw a Kautzky's Sporting Goods on the bottom here. Kautzky's Lazy Ike. So this would have been an older one. This is probably sometime in the 50s,
maybe even earlier, so I'm sure I'll go ahead and toss that out and lose it later. Now, in the 1962 Popular Mechanics article, 12 Deadly Lures, the Lazy Ike was featured, and they give you kind of a little bit of a pro tip to use a snap-on and a swivel, and this will give you a little bit of weight to get this to sink down, so because these are floating lures, so they likely will come up to the top, so this will keep it down. And I love the motion on this too. I'll show you some water motion, but it's got a real tight wiggle on this. And I think, you know, this time of year, it being January, it's cold. Something this small and a real tight presentation and having the weight on it to keep it down. So when you do stop, it kind of slowly goes to the top. I think that's kind of what you need for this time of year, just to kind of keep it slower and downsize. So let's get on the water, see if we can catch a fish. Pulling out the big guns here. Gonna see if old Uncle Josh can help out. So in that article, they mentioned just putting a little soft plastic worm to entice the bite. But I figured, hey, let's give old Uncle Josh a chance. Let's just go ahead and show the movement, the water. This is really awesome. If you can see that, check the real tight wiggle. And having this swivel up front just adds a little bit of weight, keeps it down. Welp, maybe better give it a week. So as we wait for the world outside to de-thaw, I figured let's take a little closer look at the Lazy Ike. Now, the Lazy Ike was certainly not a one-size-fits-all type lure. There's many different sizes, colors, variation, and they went from size 00, which was a little less than an inch and a half, all the way to 5, which was about 4.5 inches. So let me show you what I'm talking about here. So here's an example of a number 4, and this is 3.5 inches. Like I said, it goes to number 5, which would be a 4.5 inch. And it's painted here in that quintessential Lazy Ike color, which is the white body, red head with the eyes painted on as well. And as we see, we go down the list, they get smaller and smaller. And then we have an example here of a 0, not a double 0, but this is 1¾ inch long. Now I also have something here that I think is pretty rare because I can't find anything about it. So I'm gonna need a little homework from you guys to let me know what this is. Now, Lazy Ike made a plug more or less, but this is not it. This looks like a Lazy Ike, but it's got an upper plug type lip up here. If anybody can tell me what this is, I would love to know. I can't find anything on it. So you viewer, let me know, what the heck is this? Now, I love collecting vintage lures, and it's really like collecting anything else. Let's say classic cars, for example. Now, you're gonna have those folks that like Corvettes and those other folks that like to collect Corvairs. And they're both great in their own right. Corvette's gonna be a little bit more expensive, it's gonna be faster, obviously more desirable, but the Corvair can be just as fun as well, and the perfect way to get into the classic car market. Super cheap, affordable, made a ton of them, millions of those made, and really just a lot of fun. And so I think the Lazy Ike is kind of the Corvair for vintage fishing lures. And what I mean by that, it's not a diss by any means. There's millions of these made. They have a variety of different colors, sizes, options. Heck, you can even get into jigs, you can get into spinners, and you're not gonna break the bank. It's a really affordable lure. So you're not gonna throw a creek chub out in the water that's, you know, worth $75 to $100, but you could buy a whole bunch of these for $2 to $5 a piece on eBay, and you could collect them, and you can cast them, and just have an absolute blast with them. Yeah,
just great. Yeah, why do I live here again? Huh. I might have one more option.
All right, so I have one more spot in mind, and it's actually a power plant lake with a hot water spillway. So the water should be thawed out. Now, where I'm thinking about going is a sketchy little bridge next to a boat ramp where people usually have their trailers stolen while they're out fishing. So it's the kind of place, you know, you leave your wallet and keys inside your truck unlocked, and it'll be fine. Nothing could go wrong. So let's go check this place out and see if we can find a fish. Here, I mean, check this out. Hey, you know, this is the best water I've seen in weeks. So let's give it a shot.
All right, here we go. Maybe not.
Got this all sort of tangled up. Nice, beautiful. What did I do? Great, it's on my sleeve. Fantastic.
So what's cool about this area right here in the summertime and spring, you'll see a lot of people kind of cruising back and forth, and they've got deep diving crankbaits, and what they're looking for are wipers, which is a striped bass, white bass hybrid. And there's actually quite a few in here. That would be awesome to hook into one of those today. But man, I'll be happy with anything, really. But it's been super slow and super cold.
Well, swing and a miss, strike two. I think I'm going to call it for the day. Just not quite working out. These fish haven't woke up yet. I actually saw a dude come down here with his boat, and he was going to try to back it in right here. And I want to say that'd be a little bit of a challenge, but, you know, whatever. He drove off pretty quick. So I guess maybe I'll wait until maybe sometime in July or August for this to thaw out and come try it again. But, no, let's give it a couple more weeks and... round three. Well, fast forward a month and we've got a few updates. First and foremost, world champs. That's right. And second, the water's thawed out. Hey, there you go. But there's still no fish. It's okay. I'm not gonna end this video until we catch something on Lazy Ike. So if it takes me until June to do it, I'm gonna do it. So let's get back out here again in another week and try again. Not giving up. No. Gosh. Well, the good news is it's a nice day. The bad news is this is now my fourth, fifth, I don't know. Lost track, I have no idea. Attempt. Still nothing. And a hook fell off. I mean, it's good. I still have the lure. Just now it's only got half the hooks. So I guess we'll try again next week or something. I don't know. We'll keep going. Now, I've almost forgot what a fish looks like at this point. Am I discouraged? Yes. Am I giving up? Absolutely not. No. I think I need to catch a fish. We got to catch a fish on this. And quite frankly, I'm not doing myself a whole lot of favors if you think about it. I mean, I am, or I was, now it's March. I was fishing in January and February, typically the most difficult times to fish. That's when fish are usually completely shut off. So I wasn't doing myself any favors. Maybe a more skilled angler could have snagged a fish or two. And I got a couple nibbles here and there. But yeah, not going to give up. I think this is a great springtime lure. At least that's what I'm telling myself. It's got a lot of good action. I think it can catch fish. Obviously, it's sold millions, so somebody somewhere was catching fish with it. Not me personally, but someone somewhere. So we're going to keep going. We're not giving up. So let's see what next week brings. Crossing fingers. Can't get any worse than this. All right, folks. It's time to stop farting around. It's time to find some fish. Let's bring out the big guns. Let's get the boat on the water. There it is.
there you have it, folks. See, took almost, you know, limited to no effort to try to get this. So, and the hook came out. So, yeah. Okay, I did it. Yes. And with really little to no effort at all. Certainly didn't take me 6 trips, multiple times in the water to find this, but hey, it's a good way to start your day. Nice little bass too. And he's got a little souvenir in his mouth. So I can't believe it. The hook came out. There you go.
Well, last but not least, I have to show you this. That bass was meant to be, because this happened right after I caught it. That, on top of this right here, where the hook came out in the actual bass. So, hey, you know what? We caught the fish, finished the video. All is great in the world. So, until next time, folks, we'll see you on the water. Well, if I have any gear left,